Hello, and in today's video I'm going to load a image into the EEPROM of the PIC and then display it on the terminal or PuTTY console. Now the base setup of the code is I have the variables associated with the UART, which is the data, if I've gotten data, and the print buffer for if I need to print out something. Then we have the EEPROM read function and the EEPROM write function. The setup of these functions you can look at one of my previous videos. Then we have the high and low priority forward declaration functions, the oscillator configured to 8 MHz, the UART initialized at 9600 baud, the interrupt setups, and then a printout to tell me my program has started. Then we have our infinite loop, the UART receive in the high priority interrupt, and then the low priority interrupt has nothing inside of it. Now to start the code, we add a boolean at the top of main, and we'll call it start read, and we'll just tag it as a bool, initialize it as false. Then another uint 16, call it image size counter, initialize it as zero. Then we go to the infinite loop, we add a if got data bool is true, we do the following. Now the got data bool comes from the UART receive function, and that just tells the main loop that there is new data to be processed. Now after we have received data, we call the function EEPROM right, we give it image size counter and we pass in data. Now what this does is every time we receive data, write into the current placeholder for image size, and then write the value of data into the EEPROM at the location of image counter size. Then next we say UART send character carriage return. Now since EEPROM write has a while loop in it, this just tells the PC that the data has been written to the EEPROM and we can proceed. Then we increment the value of the image size counter, then we add a if statement, we use image size counter is greater or equals to 256. And then if this condition is met, we reset image size counter. Then we add another condition with if data is equivalent to character X, we use the start read bool we declared above is equals to true. And then the got data bool is equals to false. Then we take this whole shebang, we encase it in another if. We say the data equivalent to X, and we say if not equivalent to X. You just give a quick compile. Why is the compiler not happy? Somewhere a bracket is missing. Or one too many brackets. Just remove that one. Move that down. Okay, now we recompile. Okay, compiler is happy. Underneath the got data bool if statement, we add another if, and this if is if start read bool is true, then we need to print out the image. I'm just gonna copy over a print buffer from my pre-written code. This just shows that we are currently printing out the image to the console. We declare a variable uint 8 res count equals to zero. Now res count will be used to set the line, since we are going to read in the image as a single array of values. So the res count will be used to count the number of horizontal lines, and if we reach 16, start on a new line. I will explain this further when we start loading in the image. Then we create a for loop. We make a uint 16, call it I for my counter, and I is less than 256, and I is incremented once. Now the reason I'm using a uint 6 here is because a uint 8 can't go to 256 in value. You'll just get an infinite loop and this condition will never be true. For example, you'll get to 255 value and then the variable will overflow and go to 0. And then again 255 and you'll never reach 256. And in the for loop, declare a uint 8 and call it read data is equals to EEPROM read, and we pass in I as the address we are going to read. So this will read all the addresses from EEPROM 0 to 255. And then we add a if, and we say if data is equivalent to 0, then we uart send a blank character or white space. Then we copy this data over. We say if data read is equivalent to 255, print 178. Now 178 is a solid block in the ASCII table. Then our reset counter gets incremented by 1. And then if reset count is equivalent to 16, we do a uart send, another send, we replace it with backslash n, so new line feed, and then backslash r, which is a carriage return. And then we set reset count equal to 0. And then since we exit the if, we say start bool is equals to false. And we give a quick compile. Okay, and then we program the PIC. Now that the PIC's programmed, let's have a look at the Python code. Now in the Python code, I'm using the serial library to open a serial port so I can communicate with the PIC. I'm using OpenCV to load in my images. And that's the only two libraries I'm using. Now this code is fairly simple. I try to open a serial port. This variable is pointless, so I'm going to remove it. I try to open a serial port. If there's no serial port, just exit the code. Then I load an image from this path, and I can't remember what this parameter is. And k is also a useless value. Then I print out the image array, which will be a NumPy array. And then I simply start printing out the 2D array that is generated by OpenCV for the length of the image array. This needs to be altered to J. Then we have the image here. Now this is just to normalize the values because I saw some funny values when I was running the code that a black pixel is not represented always as 0. So I just force it to be 0. And then else it's represented as a white pixel. And then I do a byte conversion of the array so that I can write it to the serial port. Then I wait for a carriage return from the PIC and then we start the loop again. And then the exit of the code, we just close the serial port. Or if there's no serial port for some reason, just do no port open. Okay, now let's discuss the image that I'm going to load in. Now the image I'm going to load in is this image. So the size of the image will be 16 by 16. Black pixels will be represented as 0. And white pixels will be represented as 255 as their values. Now the image itself is 16 by 16, and if we have a look in Paint, the internal EEPROM of the PIC has 255 bytes available, and an image is a two-dimensional object that goes like this. So the maximum we can fit in is pixels squared. If it's a exactly the same width and height of the image. So for 255, so we have 16 squared, which is equals to 255. most images you'll process on microcontrollers will be in a linear fashion and not in a two-dimensional array fashion, just the way our RAM works. Now, another thing is you can, if it's a monochrome image, so say you have only black and white, you can use each individual bit as a representation, but that's a bit out of scope for this video. Now back to running the Python code. Now the Python code will be loaded with py load underscore image dot py. So look, see, this must be changed back to I. Clear the screen. Okay, now here you can see the reason why I used the upper and lower limits to designate a value. Well, here we have 254 instead of 255 representing a white pixel. And again here, and I'm pretty sure there's a few others, and then a black pixel here represented as 19 instead of 0 like the rest. You can already see the image in Python being printed out here as the letter B and the letter T over here. Now I'm going to open a PuTTY console with the image and then display the image on the PuTTY console. Now as soon as I press X on the keyboard to PuTTY, the image will display. Now as you can see, white pixels are represented as these pixel squares and black pixels are represented as blank spaces. So technically the image is inverted. So what you can do as well is, when we go back to the code, we can invert it by just flipping these two lines. Let me program the PIC quickly. Now the multiple program starts you see is just the PIC reprogramming. Let me reset the console. We press X again and nothing. Why nothing? We need to reload the image in. So we go back to... Oh, by the way, reprogramming your PIC erases the EEPROM unless you set it otherwise. We just quickly run in the image. Need to close the PuTTY. Okay, the image is reprogrammed into the PIC. Let me press X again, and the image is inverted. And that's a basic introduction of loading images into microcontrollers. Any code that I've written will be linked on my Git. Any parts that I've used will be linked down in the description. A like, share, comment, and subscribe would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. Have a nice day.